We haven't left you, Doug.
Oh, yeah, I'm fine.
And you received your package with the prior minutes meeting and all that by email, didn't you?
I got it here in front of me.
That's what I thought. We have a Ms. Lydia Tisdale with us today. It appears she's going to be filming us. We're going to be stars.
Yes, indeed. You certainly will be.
Well, good thing I'm not there.
Will anyone else be joining me this morning?
No.
Okay. If I may, I'm going to go around to that other corner.
That's fine.
Because of the light in the window. Let me scoot behind you, sir.
You got the whole room.
Thank you very much. I appreciate that. Excellent. Thank
you,
ma'am.
That's actually our agenda.
Straight up, is your recorder on?
I will put it on right now. It is going.
I'll officially call the meeting to order this morning, March the 5th. And it's at 9 o'clock, and we have with us Doug Sorrells, our member, who is has been under the weather, and he's with us by phone. Has all the package that we'll be covering. All this for the record, we welcome a guest, Ms. Tisdale. And, so we'll go right into the meeting. We review the minutes of the last meeting for February the 6th. I have read them and I see no problem in them.
No, and I had received an email from Matt, and he has read them also and did not have any issues with them.
I'll make a move that they be approved as written.
All right, we have a move, and I will second that they be approved as written. And all in favor, I guess it'll have to be a voice vote with you this time.
Okay, aye.
Aye here, the motion carried unanimously. And for the record, Doug Blender is out of town, and he's so far out of town, it would have been before daylight to wake him up this time, so two's quorum. All right, the next thing is old business. Barb?
We have the March 6th presidential preference primary and special election update. We're all ready for it. We've had really good advanced voting. I've got that in my supervisor's report as far as the numbers go. We had a good pickup yesterday with the managers. To let you know, Joel Knapp will continue to serve as the Republican vote review panelist. And Wilma Turner is also going to return with us. However, she's unable to be at this one due to a death in the family. So Susan Gunter will be finding an additional person to serve on that panel with us this election. The other thing that we have is House Bill 829, changing our House districts, that has been approved. Signed by the governor and is off to justice to be approved, so after this election we'll be able to put those into effect as well. So we won't have to use the other ones, we can go with the current ones to do our redistricting.
Right,
that'll be good.
So, and that's about all the old business we have. It's going to be a short meeting.
Okay, well, any new business?
I have no new business.
Only question I got is, will the certification for the election tomorrow, when will it be? Will it be Friday?
It will be Friday after the close of business, so it'll have to be 4:30 because we have to wait until all of the military ballots have a chance to come in, and we have to wait until the close of business, so that'll be...
Well, Well, give me a call. I will make arrangements to come in. If you need my signature, I'll come in and for that
okay.
certification. Because I think Matt's going to be out of town, isn't he?
Yes, he is still going to be out of town.
Okay.
So.
Okay.
So if you need two signatures, I'll make arrangements. I'll cover up, put my mask on, and come in like a robber.
Okay.
Okay. Well, if...
It would not take long.
If that is not, good for you, Doug, I will be glad to drive out there and bring a witness.
I think we could manage that. I've been riding around out, in the car, and there shouldn't be a whole lot of people there.
I would not think so.
Like
on
I say,
Friday
if it changes,
night.
So you just let us know, and I'll do that so it can be legal.
So Friday night at.
Friday at 4:30.
4:30.
Yeah.
Plan.
Okay. I'll put that down.
Okay.
All right. I might ask one thing about the electriever. What's the problem?
I actually have that in my report, too.
Well, we better just let you go ahead with your report, then. Okay. We're through with your business.
As far as the supervisor's report, and Doug, I will send you a copy of this as soon as we're done here.
Okay.
As of March 1st, we have 98,403 active, 11,057 inactive, for a total of 109,460. We've processed quite a few new and transfers this time. We've had over 700 new and transferred voters that have come into Forsyth in the month of February. As far as absentee by mail, we mailed out 658 ballots, and we have already received 516 back. Early voting, we had 2,163 here in the office. And advance voting, we had 3,986 for just that last week. So we've had a total of 6,149 for the early and advance, which I think is very, very good.
Good.
It was a good steady stream up here. The office handled it well. As far as the supplies, they're all packed. The poll managers have picked their supplies up yesterday, and delivery is off to a good start today. Mandy and Betsy are both over there. They've taught the parks and water guys how to set up the equipment, and they've reviewed that with them. And Tim had come in from the water department, who drives our box truck, and they're already delivering as we speak. What Donald was talking about was the Electriever. Southern Business, who is the gentleman that did come out and show us the Electriever, did win the bid on the Electriever for a bid of $32,905. Nydia, so you know what that is. It's a large rotating file cabinet that will help us speed up our filing and do all of that. It's a lot of counties have them, and we've just gotten to the degree that we had to have something that was better than sitting on the floor trying to file in the file cabinets. So
you have four drawer file cabinets.
They're actually seven drawer.
Yes,
there's seven drawer file cabinets.
And for the bottom drawers, you have to sit on the floor to do it.
Yeah.
This will speed all of that up tremendously.
Delivery date, did he give you an estimate?
He has not yet. I have not spoken with him. The bid just got in on...
Where will that be? Will it be in the warehouse? Or?
Yes, it's going to be in that locked room in the warehouse where the files are kept now.
Okay.
So, and it will fit in there, and... We'll keep some of the old cabinets for deleted and purged files, and we have the room next to it that we've been keeping a lot of files in as well, and both those rooms are locked.
Okay.
It's on the new side, so it's, not too many people are coming into that location, so. And that's all I have as far as my supervisor report. It's short. We've been so busy with elections that... Mm-hmm.
I'd like to go on the record of saying we had nothing but compliments about Saturday voting.
We
and,
did.
We had a lot of people come in with special circumstances that Saturday fit them so well. And
we had 447 that came in on that Saturday and voted.
I worked half the day on that, and it was, for a change, it was enjoyable.
Wonderful.
That's good.
But is there any other new business you know of?
I have no other business.
I know of nothing myself. Doug, I would might say I know you take the Forsyth County News. I had a little article in there rebutting a copy of an LA Times article about deceased voters being on active lists.
Mm-hmm.
And I had to write one rebutting that we do it better here.
Yeah, I hope so.
And we have a process statewide and locally. And I just couldn't let that ride that our people read the other article and just thought everybody was bad.
Yeah.
So that was the reason for it.
Well, thank you for doing that.
And I don't have anything else.
Well, I don't either, and I'll see you Friday night. So nothing else, I might move with adjourn.
Okay, and I'll second the move, and all in favor?
Aye.
I hear. Most carried unanimously, and the meeting is adjourned.
All right. Talk
Thank
to you,
you.
Later.
Yeah, and look forward
day,
to seeing
Doug.
You Friday.
Okay, bye.
Okay, bye.
Thank you very much. And thank you for that explanation. I'm sorry, I didn't catch your name.
It's Barbara Luth.
Oh, hello. I've emailed you several times. It's nice to finally meet you.
I'm the supervisor.
Thank you, Ms. Luth.
Yeah, no problem.
And I'm obviously the chair of the board and the chief registrar and the one who finally gets blamed.
The ultimate responsibility.
He is.